This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to be using the basic identities, in particular the reciprocal identities and how to write cotangent and tangent in terms of sines and cosines, to simplify trig expressions. And we're going to do that for these two problems. You should have already learned these basic trig identities, the reciprocal identities, the tangent and cotangent written in terms of sine and cosine, and the three Pythagorean identities, sometimes called the fundamental identities. So we're going to use these to do some simplifying. So let's try this. Write the expression in terms of sine and cosine and simplify. Okay, so we have cotangent x over the cosecant of x. So what we could do is use the reciprocal identities. We want to write these in terms of sine and cosine. So the cotangent is the same thing as the cosine of x over the sine of x. The cosecant of x is 1 over the sine of x. All right, so now we have these everything written in terms of sines and cosines. And so now I have a complex fraction. So remember what that means. That means cosine of x over sine x divided by the 1 over sine x, which is the same thing as the cosine of x over sine x times the reciprocal. So that'll be sine x over 1. All right, now we can cancel here. These divide out. And we have in the numerator cosine x over 1, but anything over 1 is just the numerator. So I have now finished simplifying my problem. So cotangent x over cosecant of x is a complicated way of just simply writing the cosine of x. Here is our next example, sine of x over secant x tangent x. So let's first write them in terms of sines and cosines. And I want to make sure you understand there isn't just one way to do any of these problems. All right, so if we first just write everything in terms of sines and cosines, well, I already have the numerator in terms of sines, so I leave that. But secant of x is the same thing as 1 over the cosine of x. And tangent is the sine of x over the cosine of x. So this is what I have so far. So nothing cancels in the denominator, so I basically have sine of x over sine of x over cosine squared x. And now I can think of this as the whole numerator divided by the denominator. So that is sine of x, and I'm going to write that as sine of x over 1, divided by the sine of x over the cosine of x squared, right? That's cosine squared x. And then I can multiply by the reciprocal. So that's sine of x over 1 times cosine squared x over the sine of x. Now I'm aware most people can go directly from this step to that step, just times it by the reciprocal of the denominator. That's completely fine. Just showing all the steps for those who have trouble. So let's see, the sines cancel, and that's all that cancels. So I have cosine squared x over 1, which is the same thing as cosine squared x. So that's one way of simplifying the original, which was sine of x over secant x tangent of x. Now let me show you another way you might have thought of it. So here we are again with the original, sine of x over secant x tangent x. What some people do is when they see a secant x, they know that they can if the secant is the denominator, it's the same thing as the cosine in the numerator. So for instance, what we could do there is we have the sine x in the numerator, and then you could just bring the secant up, but when it comes up, it's the reciprocal, right? So it's going to be the cosine of x. Same thing with the tangent. When you see a tangent in the denominator, what you could do is write that as a cotangent in the numerator because those are reciprocals. Now notice that would leave just a 1 in the denominator, so basically you don't even need these fraction bars. And this is another way that some people might start the problem, which is perfectly fine. And at this point, I'm going to change my cotangent x to cosine over sine. So this would look like this. I'd have the sine x, I've got this cosine x, and then this is written as cosine of x over the sine of x. And again, you could think of these as over 1. If that's helpful, do that. And so I can cancel the sine x, and I still end up with cosine times cosine, so that's the cosine squared x. Don't forget to always write the argument, the x. Don't just put cosine squared. So I got the same answer as the first way I did it. All right, so that's another option. In other words, what I'm saying is if you have, we know that secant x equals 1 over cosine x. 1 over secant x is the same thing as cosine x, right? You usually see it written this other way. Cosine of x is 1 over secant, but basically if you see 1 over secant, it means you could put cosine in the numerator. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.